Genshin Impact's latest live stream has officially come underway, which means that we can start talking about the Natland characters. And in today's video, we're going to talk about Mualani. Again, I'm sure I'm saying it wrong, but I don't care. She's a 5-star Catalyst Hydro user. This is her Ascension card, mostly containing materials found in Natland, so you can't really prepare for her. And this is going to end up being the banner that she'll be available in. So let's get right into it. Her elemental skill, Surf Shark Wave Breaker. Combining her mastery of speed and the waves and water, Mualani can surf anytime, anywhere. After using this skill, Mualani will gain 60 Night Soul points and enter the Night Soul's Blessing state. The Night Soul Blessing for Mualani will continuously consume Night Soul points. When they are depleted, or when the skill is used again, Mulani's Night Soul's Blessing will end. The state itself has the following traits. Mualani mounts her Sharky Surfboard, increasing her movement speed and interruption resistance. She can also move on water and liquid phlogiston while this state is active, and she will take no damage from the latter. Normal attacks will be converted to Sharky's Bites, dealing Night Soul aligned hydro damage based on Mulani's max HP. Sharky Bites can be used mid-air. Damage dealt this way is considered normal attack damage. When she makes contact with opponents while in this state, Mualani applies Marked as Prey to them and gains one wave momentum stack. Goes to a maximum of 3 stacks. One stack can be gained from the same opponent every 0.7 seconds. Now for the wave momentum and Marked as Prey, when Mualani uses Shark Bite, her damage dealt increases based on wave momentum stacks. When she has 3 stacks, a normal attack will use Sharky's Surging Bite instead, further increasing her damage and removing all her attack stacks at once. When Sharky's Bite hits an opponent marked as prey, that mark is removed and she will fire shark missiles up to 5 nearby opponents marked as prey, dealing damage to them equal to this Sharky's Bite instance and clearing their marks. If more than one opponent is the target of Sharky's Bite and shark missiles, the damage dealt will decrease, with 28% being the maximum decrease when at least 3 opponents are targeted. Her ultimate ability, Stormburst Shot, fires a super shark missile that can track opponents, dealing Night Soul aligned area of effect hydro damage based on Mulani's max HP. Moving on to her passive abilities. The trick is to keep smiling. While in an area with phlogiston mechanics within Natland, 15 phlogiston will be restored when interacting with some harvestable items. Additionally, the location of nearby resources unique to Natland will appear on your minimap. Night Realm's Gift. After her Night Soul points are depleted, Mualani will switch to consume phlogiston to maintain her Night Soul's Blessing. While in an area with phlogiston mechanics within Natland, she can use Night Soul Transmission Mualani. When the active character is currently sprinting, swimming, or in a movement state caused by certain talents or skills, or at a certain height within the air, the following will trigger when switching to Mualani. Mualani will enter the Night Soul's Blessing state and gain 40 Night Soul points. Night Soul Transmission can be triggered once every 10 seconds by your own team. Additionally, Mulani's Night Soul point or phlogiston consumption while moving on water and liquid phlogiston during Night Soul's Blessing is decreased by 75% while in Natland, and her Night Soul point consumption is decreased by 35% while doing the same outside of Natland. Her next passive, Heat Resistant Freshwater Puffer. When Sharky's Surging Bite hits an opponent, a puffer will be generated nearby. Mualani will restore 20 Nightshade points when she picks up a puffer. Only 2 such puffers can be created in this way during a single instance of being in the Night Soul Blessing. In her last passive, Natland's Greatest Guide, when a nearby party member triggers a Night Soul Burst, Mualani gains 1 stack of Wave Chaser's Exploits, which lasts 20 seconds and can have a max stack of 3. When she uses her ultimate ability, Mualani will clear all Wave Chaser Exploit stacks and increase the damage of her ultimate by 15, 30, 45% respectively of her max HP based on the number of stacks cleared. Moving on to her constellations. Her C1, the damage dealt by the first Sharky Surging Bite after Mualani enters the Night Soul's Blessing and the Shark Missile is triggered, will increase by 66% of her max HP. This instance of increased damage is subject to diminishing damage rules of Surf Shark Wavebreaker. In addition, while out of combat, Mulani's Night Soul Blessing state consumes 30% less phlogiston and Night Soul points. Her C2, Mualani gains 2 of Surf Shark Wavebreaker's wave momentum stacks when she enters Night Soul Blessing. She will gain 1 stack when obtaining a puffer. In addition, whenever Mualani obtains 2 puffers within a single instance of the Night Soul Blessing, she will recover an additional 12 Night Soul points over 2 seconds. This effect requires the passive talent, Heat Resistant Freshwater Puffer. Her C3 increases her elemental skill by 3 levels. Her C4, Mualani regenerates 8 energy when obtaining a puffer. Of course, you have to unlock the puffer pass passive ability first, and additionally, Stormburst Shot deals 75% increased damage. Her C5 increases her ultimate by 3 levels, and her C6, the damage increase from her C1 is no longer limited to being triggered once every Night Soul Blessing. While this character is really cool, I am just so flabbergasted at the idea that they've locked movement abilities behind these characters. Don't get me wrong, they're really, really cool, but you ain't tricking me, Genshin.